Hi everybody, and welcome to Kendall Young Library's Adult DIY for December 2020. We have a beautiful Christmas tree book that we're going to do. I think it's beautiful, I should say. This is what your product will look like when you're finished, we hope. So, I will mention that we had two churches in town give us some of their hymnals that they were probably replacing or just were gracious enough to donate them to the library. So thank you for that. So what you'll be getting in your kit today is a hymnal. You'll be getting a silhouette of some houses, 10 snowflakes, one Santa and reindeer, a tree, some trees, a snowman, a little square, and a moon. I will mention, we cut these out with a Cricut, and some of the silhouettes have tiny little things that might not have gotten cut out all the way, so you sure could take a paper clip or a safety pin or whatever you might have that could pop those out, but it's very simply, you can pop those out just to get everything poked out. We really, really work that Cricut to get all of these done. It's a wonderful little machine. These are very intricate designs. Make sure we get that all the way through. Okay, that is our moon. Also, you get a moon. I think one of my snowman's eyes are all poked out. I thought there was one of my windows that I wanted to, get all the way out. It's amazing how intricate that Cricut can cut out the designs. You're also going to get some glue. Some of you might have clear glue. It may look like there's nothing in there, but there is glue in the little cup. A Q-tip to apply the glue with. And some different types of sequins. There's some larger ones that are a little bit thicker and some really thin ones. And they may actually have more than one there. And then some tiny little gold sequins. I'm going to move my paper just because I want it to be as close to me as possible. You will also get a instruction sheet. I did make a mistake on this, and I hope everybody can read past it. I was editing it, thinking I was making it easier to follow, and I actually forgot step three, although it is in step two, and the pictures are correct at the bottom. So hopefully that won't make it more difficult for anybody. Okay, so what we're going to start with is how you're going to start is you're going to go, I'm going to move this back, I should have moved this back. Oh, and you're also going to get a strip of, is actually a scrapbook paper that we've glued together to make it long enough. I will tell you, this project took a lot of people to put together, and we have some wonderful people at the library that we just really worked together to get this one done. I'm so excited. Okay, so what we do is we want to go ahead and open your hymnal, and you sure can use a book from home or something that's special to you that you want to keep a hold of. You know, something that's a keepsake or something like that. Obviously, it's kind of tough to ruin a good book, and we hate to do that, but sometimes if it's something that's sitting around and we're really not using, we can use it for something else. And that's what we've decided to do here. So what we're going to do is the first thing you do is kind of find the center of your books. You can sure do that by the number. I'm not a number person. I kind of go by my eyes. So I have just divided this into what looks to me to be about half. And I finally counted the pages I folded, and I come to 75. You can sure do however many you want, but that's what I did on both of these trees. So what you're going to do is to make your first fold. Oh, I will mention, when you get to the pages where you're going to put your silhouettes on, I am kind of picky about things. I actually found some Christmas songs that I wanted to be the base of my silhouettes. So what I did was cut those pages out of the book so that I could put those in that place, just because you don't know where you're going to end up. So I put that the ends on both ends so that that's where my silhouettes are. I think I have Joy to the World and Little Town of Bethlehem If it doesn't matter to you, then you don't need to worry about that part. So how we start off is we're going to go ahead and, as it states in, you find the center page of our book, we're going to fold that page down into a triangle. So we're taking the corner and taking it as far in as we can go. And this is kind of tough up here in the point, and sometimes it's going to tear, and that's okay because it will be covered, but we still are going to try and take it as close to the edge as we possibly can. And if you can do that with most of the pages, it'll be as symmetrical as possible. I'm sorry, I'm going ahead. Okay, so you take that and you've got a triangle. So then what we're going to do is take that edge and we're going to fold it into the center. So here we go. So I took that edge and I folded it to the center and fold like this. Now you have a small little flap, and that's where I messed up on the stages here on the numbers, but we have a small flap at the bottom. We just, if you fold that against the edge of your book, you can then push it, put it into the fold. So there's actually a little hollow spot inside your fold there, and I have tucked that corner into there. So that gives it a nice flat edge. Okay, so we are going to do that for 75 pages, or however many you want. One thing I will suggest to do is to, and as you go along and it gets to be more and more pages, I find that you really kind of hold this down so that you can get that fold in. If you can't get them as close as, try to make them as symmetrical as possible, you'll have a lot of waves in how your book looks. So, not that it is absolute, but to get that best symmetry, that's the way to go. So here we go, another one. And you fold it in, kind of hold that tip, fold it down, and then holding that flush against that bottom again, made a flap and pushed it up. Okay, and we're just going to continue on. I'll do one more page in this one. You are not going to have to watch me fold 75 pages, but I want to give you an idea of how this looks. You can always unfold it and refold it if you're not happy with the way it turned out. Once you start doing it, you kind of get the feel for it, and it's not so bad. Okay, so I've got three pieces right there. And so what I'm going to do is be sure to take some from this side and some from this side. That'll make sure that your tree is in the center. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and move this one out of the way because I'm not going to have you watch me fold 75 pages. So I'm going to go ahead and move that back out of the way. And I'm going to go ahead and bring this one over here, which I have 74 pages folded, and I'm going to finish that very last one. This, like I said, gets kind of tight, so you got to have to push it back. Oh, wait a minute, I'm sorry, I glued down the page I wanted here. This is a Christmas song, the first Noel. So this would have been the side I need to fold. Okay, and I had glued that down before, just to kind of show you. It takes a little finesse, but you know what? You kind of get the feel of it after you've done it 75 times. Okay, so now I've got 75 there, and I am happy with that. I can set it up, and it sets up just fine, and I like the way that it looks. You can do more, you can do less. That sure is up to you. So then, this was what I was talking about. I had taken out another. It came upon a midnight clear, and I wanted it on this side because this isn't a Christmas song, and I'm not happy with that. So I had cut it and trimmed it to fit, and all I'm going to do is take that back out and just take a small amount of glue. It doesn't take a lot, and just kind of run it along that seam. And again, you don't have to do this. It's just a suggestion. Anybody that knows me know I'm funny about stuff like that. Okay, so there we go. So now I have two Christmas songs on both sides of my page, which is where I'm going to put my silhouettes. Okay, so now we can glue down our silhouettes, and you can decide where you're going to put yours. I'm going to go ahead and follow the book that I did before. So what I did previously was I took this house, and I liked the way this looked. So I put it here, kind of positioned it there. So you do want to make sure you put a generous amount of glue on there. These are really thick cardstock. and the edges especially. And it, you know, it can curl up a little bit when you get it glued down, so you sure could put something heavy on top of it if you wanted to. And I'm going to do this rather quickly so that you're not watching me put glue on everything. Okay. So I'm going to place this inside here where I want it. I'm going to pull it out as far as I can because I want it to be shown. The tree kind of hides it, which is okay. And obviously you can see some of mine's popping up because I didn't use as much glue as I probably should have, but okay. So there's the houses. And we're just gonna continue on with that. I want to put my moon up here. You see, I can kind of place them a little bit, get an idea of where I want them. And then I think, yeah, I did this trees this way. And again, it's up to you what you want to do. So that's kind of where I wanted to go with those. So I'm gonna go ahead and glue those down. I was trying to play some light Christmas music. I keep getting this Mr. Grinch and Charlie Brown. Let's not have the right station. Anyway, okay, so I'm gonna put my moon this way. And then, Santa's sled and reindeers. Isn't that amazing? I just find this amazing how intricate these cuts are. Just love it. We would not have been able to do this DIY. Obviously during a program it just would have took way too long. So I'm kind of excited that we get to do it at all. And thank goodness for all the donations of hymnals. Gosh, love things. Okay, so that's down. I'm gonna put my trees down. It's good to kind of place things, see where you want them to go, because once you got them glued, well, it'll be harder to move. So now the snowflakes, oh my gosh, they're so tiny. So it might be better to just put the glue on where you want it, I think. Because trying to get glue on there, and you do have, should have 10, I hope you do. We tried really hard to be sure everybody had the same amount. So you should have 5 for either side if you wish to put it that way. And there are several different kinds, which makes it kind of fun. No two snowflakes are alike, so they say. Okay, so we got 5 on there. And the folding's the thing that takes so long. Now we're making our star, or the top of our tree, will take a little bit too. But I will kind of do that quickly too for you. Okay, so the silhouettes are down and mine are not as good as they should be because I should have took more time, but okay. So there's our glue. Now we get to decorate the tree. And so you can kind of lay out your sequins here and decide where you want to put your colors. Some of them are very fine. They're actually confetti, but that was cost effective to get you lots of different colors. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to, and you do have to put a bit of glue on here to keep them on. So I'm going to go ahead and pick it up with my glue and lay it out. That actually kind of works best. Or you could do the same thing we did with snowflakes. But be sure you get lots of glue on there because I have seen that they've not stayed on as well as I would like. Personally, I used a glue gun on mine. You sure can if you've got one at home. Obviously, we couldn't give everybody a glue gun, so this will work. But I kind of like a glue gun because that's so fast. Get results fast. That's the way I like it. Okay. All right. Kind of use your dry end of your... And they do have two sides. Some of them are two different colors, just so you know. Let's see, we got one down here. Another red one. We have lots of red over there. There it is. Okay. I have a lot of silver for some reason. Not a bad thing, just saying. And we tried to give everybody the same amount of sequins, but they did kind of stick together a bit, so hopefully everybody has plenty. I actually made one of these and used buttons. Gosh, there's so many things. And I used some old jewelry that I love the jewelry, but I didn't really want to wear it. It was something that was just really cool looking. So I cut it apart and I glued my jewelry on it, and I love that one. Sure is lots of things you can do. This is just one option. Okay, blue. I'm sorry, you're just kind of watching me slowly glue these down. How rather monotonous, but okay. Personally, I like lots, so I'm gonna try to put as many as I can on here. I'm pretty happy with that. I think we'll stop there. Now, the tiny ones. This is a tough thing, but oh my gosh, I think they really, really, really add. And oh, by the way, you want to save back one of these for your center if you want to put one in your center. So this is tricky, but it's so worth it. If you have a toothpick, maybe that would work, but I have been putting glue on my tree and then just kind of dropping them where my glue is. Good luck. But they're such a neat little detail, and it really adds, I think, personally adds a lot to them. So I know it takes patience, but it's worth it. Okay, come over here. Oh, for goodness sake, I don't know where that went. Oh, there it went. Fingers are starting to get sticky. Should dry clear, so if you get some globs, it's all right. I'm not gonna put any up there. I will tell you that your top should cover most of that, so you may not want to put a bunch up there, because if you decide to use our top, it may not show. Okay, I think I'll finish stop there, just so you're not watching me continue on my quest to try to show you all of those. Okay, so that is our basic tree. This is how it's come out. I'm sorry it's so far away, but I kind of want you to be able to see. So that's the way it looks there. Now, that part is pretty much finished. This is gonna be your top, and all you have to do with this strip, and what I would suggest doing is folding it in half, just to make sure that both sides are symmetrical, because that's going to make your little accordion fold symmetrical. So what you're going to do with this thing is you're going to make little accordion folds all the way up and down. And it really doesn't have to be perfect. You can always trim it with a pair of scissors if it's not exactly the way you want, but you're just folding it back and forth, accordion style. I think everybody knows what that is, but just back and forth. And I'm not gonna make you watch me do that either. Well, maybe I will because I didn't make a, so I'll go as fast as I can. So that's accordion, and you try to make them as close as to each other's size as possible, but really, I promise it's not gonna show very much if you don't. See why we couldn't do this during our DIY? Takes forever, the folding part, but it's so cool. Okay, and I think everybody knows that we're closed to the public now, which is sad, but we are still continuing our curbside, which we are thrilled about, and we are trying really hard. I don't know if everybody is signed up on our Facebook account. I wish you would, because you can go on there and reserve books. You can look at our catalog, see what's available. You can sign up for our newsletters, which they send out news. You can sign up for newsletters about the audio discs, the DVDs every month, or excuse me, every week almost. We have new books on those newsletters. So if you go to the e-books, I think it's the e-section. I can't remember exactly, but at the top of our homepage on KendallYoungLibrary.com, you will see that you can sign up for newsletters. And if you do that, you will then be getting on your email some information in regard, or all the information that's new for that week or month or whatever. And you can reserve those items. You do have to have your library card number. The 16-digit number on the back of your card. And then you have to have your PIN. Your PIN is 4 digits, which is your month and date of birth in 4-digit form. So I always say January 1st is your birthday, then your PIN would be 0101. If you have trouble with that, you can always call us and we'll be happy to help you with it. But it makes it nice for you to see what we've got available and what's new. Gosh, I'm almost ready. All right, so I've got that all folded, and this is what she looks like. Okay, so what we're going to do now is you're gonna take the two ends, and we're gonna glue those together. This can be tricky, but you can do it. I know you can. So you're just going to glue together the two ends. So now you have a circle of that accordion. Of course, it's not going to work since I'm trying to show it to you. So you glue the two ends together. Okay. Why is that not working? Okay, and so then what you're going to do, put it on the paper so you can see better. You have a little black piece of paper in your kit that you got from us. And this can be tricky, but you're going to fold that in and it makes a circle. And so what you're going to do now is you're going to take your glue and really, really, really put bunches on there, because it's got to hold this darn thing in a circular motion. Oh, mine came apart, darn it. Okay. I'm gonna try that again. This I probably would let set a little bit longer, but I don't want to make you wait on that. So again, in the circular motion, in a circular shape. And you are gonna put that on top of there. And that is gonna hopefully hold that in place. And I would suggest too, going ahead, well, maybe I shouldn't do that. Get some glue down in there. This takes a bit to get this thing to set up. So, and don't worry, because you're going to have something on top of that. What you've got to do then is you've got to find something that's heavy enough, but not too heavy to crush it, and set that on top of there to hold that in place until it dries, which can take some time. So that is what how I did that. Now, if it doesn't stick together, continue and do it once again. The more glue you can get in there, and if you can figure out a way to put something on there that's gonna hold that baby in place, and it does take some time. This is the one that I finished, so you guys could just see it, and I used just a piece of scrap paper I had, but this is what it's gonna look like when it's done. Now, if you possibly have folded it and it's a little bit crooked or it's not exactly symmetrical, you can always trim that with the scissors if you're not happy with how that turned out. So what you're gonna do now is take your finished book, and this also takes tons of glue. So we're gonna cover that baby with glue. Okay. And your paper, you are just gonna set that on top of there to the where you kinda want it. Obviously, if you wanted it farther up, you could set something underneath to kind of hold it in place until it's completely dry. And then if you want to put something in the center, one of your little discs, which of course I do, more is more. So, and again, this all needs time to dry, so you've got to kind of do this in stages if you want it to hold together for yourself. And I love this big gold one, but is that too big? I don't think so. Another one. Still got another red one I'm thinking of. Like, look kind of cool. So I'm gonna try this one. Oh yeah, I like that. Okay, so there is the tree all done that needs to dry so that you can hold it up. I will see if I can do it. I'll try. So the book that we just completed looks just like that. Now, there, you can't fold it up to put it away after the holiday, but it's still, I just think they're absolutely wonderful. And I hope that you enjoyed doing the DIY with us. And thank you very much for participating. I hope you'll get on our Facebook site and see what else we've got going on. We're trying really hard to keep things out there for you and for the children of the community. Thanks again, and have a Merry Christmas. Bye. Thank you.